Steve Magoffin produced the incredible figures of 8 for 20 as Somerset collapsed again to give Sussex a wonderful start to their latest LV County Championship game on a day in which 19 wickets fell and 374 runs were scored in Horsham. Marcus Driscothick won the toss and decided to bat, a decision he was doubtless soon regretting as McGoffin's magical day started with his 11th delivery, with which he bowled Aral Sapaya. It was Sapaya's sixth single-figure score in eight innings this season. Alvaro Peterson started his Somerset career in an outstanding fashion, but latterly things have not been too good for him. On 12 here, he gave McGoffin wicket number 2 with an LBW. Somerset have followed on with beneath-par totals in their last two games, and they were soon in bother again in Horsham when James Hildreth edged McGoffin to Chris Jordan. Alex Barrow was given his chance in the side but didn't last long either. Jordan broke McGoffin's spell with the wickets as Barrow headed off LBW with a duck to his name. And worse followed in the next over, the 14th, as the almost unplayable McGoffin had Driscothick brilliantly held behind for 20, which left Somerset on 43 for 5. Indeed, four wickets now fell without a single run being added, as McGoffin simply blew the opposition away. Peter Trigo was out two balls after Driscothick, Ben Brown clinging on again. And it was three wickets in four balls for the big Australian when Alfonso Thomas was LBW for Golden Duck, giving the bowler the ridiculous figures of 6 for 13 after seven outstanding overs. So acting Sussex skipper Chris Nash was not going to get the ball off him now. A good job as he next found the glove of Jack Leach with a brute of a delivery at 53 for 8. In their last match, Somerset had slipped to 84 for 5 in their first innings and 35 for 5 in their second. And in the game before that in Leeds, they slumped to 48 for 6 in their second dig after following on. So the signs were certainly there that their top and middle orders are in horrible form collectively. Joss Butler tried to reverse the trend, but not for long. On a top score of 22, he lost his off stump to McGoffin for his 8th wicket of a scintillating spell. He was only denied a 9 for by Steve Kirby, who nicked Jordan to Nash as Somerset were humble for just 76. McGoffin ending with 8 for 20 from 11 electrifying overs. Needless to say, such stats were the best of the Queenslander's career. It was also the best return at this ground since Vince Broderick took 9 for 35 for Northants in 1948, and the best by any Sussex player since Mushtaq Ahmed claimed 9 for 48 to clinch the title back in 2006. The whole of the Somerset innings had lasted only 22 and a half overs, and they were, somewhat amazingly, in the field before lunch on the first day. Was their collapse anything to do with the surface at this outground? Well, the way Nash and Luke Wells started their reply, the answer to that was an emphatic no. Both played their shots as they trod down forcefully on their opponents' throats. By the 16th over, they'd already taken Sussex ahead, and there was little sign of a fight back from a Somerset side, which has been oddly out of sorts since they failed to beat Warwickshire from a very advantageous position last month. The openers raced the total along to 83 for a lead of 7 in the 19th over, when there was suddenly another cluster of wickets. Wells on 30 nicked a fired-up Kirby behind. Nash, having made 46, was bowled off the inside edge by Thomas. Joe Gatting went for 4, superbly held by Driscothick, the umpires confirming that the ball had carried before giving the batsman out. And Michael Yardie was beaten all ends up by Trigo at the start of his new spell, a wicket which put Sussex on 116 for 4, 40 runs to the good. Somerset now desperately needed to continue to take wickets, just as McGoffin had done earlier. Instead, though, Rory Hamilton-Brown and Matt Machin played in a very positive manner, as Sussex, as they've done for much of the Championship season, scored their runs quickly when the opportunity arose. There were some thumping shots from both batsmen, who were ensuring that McGoffin's magic was not going to be wasted. The LV County Championship has already brought us a two-day finish, and the way that this game had moved on so very quickly, there may be a chance that this game goes the same way. Both Hamilton Brown and Machin hit sixes as they raced through the numbers, Machin with a straight hit off Leach, while Hamilton Brown soon repeated the dose. Sussex were starting to run away with things as the 200 was brought up in the 49th over. Before that was reached, Hamilton Brown secured his first 50 since the return from Surrey. He was dealing mostly in boundaries at this stage, taking on all comers and getting to his half century off only 59 balls with 8 fours and a 6. And he then celebrated that with a second maximum next ball as he took 14 runs off a Thomas over. 11 had come off the previous one delivered by Leach. The partnership of 85 between these two was only broken when Machin took on a needlessly risky single and was run out by a distant by Leach's direct hit. The batsman was gone for 26. Hamilton Brown is a very difficult man to stop when he's in one of these moods. The middle of his bat was by now getting plenty of use, and Brown was soon joining him in the hitting as Somerset were really struggling to keep a lid on the scoring. It was fast becoming a rather extraordinary day of LV County Championship cricket, made even more extraordinary by a late fight back by the visitors, who should be applauded for their efforts. On 77 from 90 deliveries, Hamilton Brown nicked a good one from Thomas to Hildreth at 232 for 6. That became 237 for 7 in the next over, with Chris Jordan falling for a duck after deflecting this ball from Trigo to Triscothic. It was 3 in 3 overs then, as Brown was legged before to a late inswinger from Thomas. Before the 19th and final wicket of the day saw James Anion caught behind off Kirby. There were still 7 overs for Somerset to finish off the second innings of the day, but just to add to the amazement, Monty Panesar now played some shots in moving to 17 and taking his side to within 2 runs of a third batting bonus point. Phew, what a scorcher of a day. The ECB pitch inspector David Capel popped along to take a look at the pitch and decided that there was nothing wrong with it. Hardly surprising after Sussex made 298 for 9 from 71 overs for a lead already of 222. What on earth can we expect from the second day of this mad match?